Euphrasia, head. Euphrasia is a short-acting remedy of great usefulness in acute catarrhal affections with or without fever. Headaches that occur with coryza are nice symptoms, headaches in the evening as if bruised. Stitching pain in the head. Headaches. As if the head would burst with dazzling of the eyes from sunlight. These are catarrhal headaches with profuse watery discharge from the eyes and nose. The eye symptoms of euphrasia are its most prominent feature. Catarrh condition of the eyes with copious, acrid, watery discharge with or without coryza. Cutting pain in the eyes extending into the head, pressure in the eyes as if caused by sand. Sensation of dryness, burning, biting in the eyes. Sensation of dust in the eyes. Violent itching of the eyes, obliging rubbing and winking, with copious lacrimation. Pupils much contracted and much tumefaction of the mucous membrane with redness and enlarged blood vessels and smarting. Iritis. From rheumatism or in connection with rheumatic joints. Copious thin or thick discharges. General inflammation of all the tissues of the eyes. Ulceration of the cornea. It has cured pannus. Pustular inflammation. Opacity of the cornea after injuries of the eye. It is suitable in the most violent acute conjunctivitis. Amblyopia with inflammation of conjunctiva and lids. Copious lacrimation and burning. The mucous membranes of the lids and eyeballs are injected, red, and vascular. Agglutination of the lids in the morning. Copious, acrid lacrimation with fluent discharge from the nose during coryza. Dryness of the lids and the margins of the lids, red, swollen, and burning. The lids are very sensitive and swollen. The margins of the lids itch and burn. Suppuration of the margins of the lids. Much swelling of the lids with inflammation. Fine rash about the eyes with puffiness of the lids. Blurred vision. Paralysis of the third nerve. The next most important group of symptoms is in connection with the nose. Sneezing and fluent coryza. The discharge is bland and this occurs with acrid lacrimation. The nasal mucous membrane is swollen. Profuse, bland, fluent, coryza. After this coryza has existed for a day or two, it extends into the larynx with a hard cough. The coryza is worse during the night while lying down. The cough is worse in the daytime and ameliorated by lying down. The remedy has a rash like measles and it has febrile symptoms. Therefore, when these symptoms are duly considered, it will be seen that euphrasia is similar to the symptoms that occur in measles. It is a wonderful medicine in measles, though not so frequently indicated as pulsatilla, owing to the fact that this combination of symptoms does not often come. Larynx and cough. Hoarseness in the morning. Irritation in the larynx compelling him to cough, followed by pressure beneath the sternum. Abundant secretion in the larynx causing loose cough with rattling in the chest. Deep inspiration is difficult. The cough, considered by itself, furnishes a very rare group of symptoms. Cough with copious expectoration along with or following coryza. Difficult respiration ameliorated at night while lying down. Worse in the morning when moving about with copious expectoration. Violent cough from tickling in the larynx. No cough at night causes the remedy to resemble brie and mang. The dyspnea and cough are ameliorated by lying down. The coryza symptoms, otherwise, are worse at night and from lying down. When these symptoms occur in grippe or influenza, this becomes a very suitable remedy. The abundance of mucus scraped from the larynx and trachea is often like the ending of bad colds. The expectoration is easy and almost without cough. It comes up without much effort. Pressive pain beneath the sternum showing that the trachea is especially involved in the catarrhal condition. The pain in the eyes is worse in the open air. The coryza is worse in the open air. The cough sometimes comes on in the open air. Windy weather causes fluent coryza. Cold air and windy weather cause lacrimation. He is a chilly patient and cannot get warm in bed. There is chill, fever, and sweat in this remedy. This chill predominates. The fever occurs mostly during the day with red face and cold hands. The heat descends the body. The perspiration is often confined to the front part of the body. Perspiration during sleep at night. Strange odor sometimes very offensive and most profuse upon the chest. It is especially suitable in catarrhal fever, influenza and measles. When the symptoms agree, it will make a violent attack of measles turn into a very simple form, making the patient feel better, bring out the eruption, control the fever, and relieve the cough, coryza, and other catarrhal symptoms. Streaming, hot burning tears with rash, photophobia, running from the nose, intense throbbing headaches, redness of the eyes, photophobia from fever, dry cough during measles.
Press the red subscribe button, then press the bell icon to get the latest updates.